Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, everyone. Nag-love shout out all the subscribers and followers of this channel. Today, we are going to study how to factor perfect square trinomial. And this is your teacher, Marife Adonis. Okay, let us review factor each difference of squares. So, we have here 49x squared minus 25. Of course, this is a perfect square, so that means 49. The square is 7x. Okay, so this is our answer. That is correct. The factors are 7x plus 5 and 7x minus 5. For 64a squared minus 81b squared, that's 81. Okay, plus 9b times 8a minus 9b. So we have here the factors of 64 is 8 and the factor of dalawang 8, no? And then for the 81, we have 9. Okay, negative and positive 9. So, this is correct. Alright. So, the expressions 144 times or 4 times 2 and 81 in the raised to 6 are called perfect square. Okay? So, these are the perfect square. Because the perfect square trinomial is a trinomial that is a square of binomial. A necessary condition for a trinomial to be perfect square is that two of its terms be a perfect squares. Even if two of the terms are perfect squares, the trinomial may not be a perfect square trinomial. Oh, let's have this example. So the factor of perfect square trinomial, we have x squared plus 2xy plus y squared, that's equal to x plus y squared. So remember, in our special product, so we have this and the product is here. This time, in factoring, it's about the other way around. So we have the factors already and we will go back to the special product. Okay. For example, we have k squared plus 20k plus 100. So, our solution is k squared plus 20k plus 100. That's k plus 10 squared. So, that's 2. So, by checking, now, so we have 2 times k times 10, that's 20k. Because your middle term should be coincides with your answer. That's it. Okay, so we have here, factor its trinomials, of course, x squared minus 24x plus 144. So, always think of a number. So, for example, 144, that is a perfect square, which is, that is a 12 square, no? 12 square for 124. That means the factors of x squared is x minus 12. So, that's 12x squared because 12 times 2 is 24, negative 24, right? So, for 25x squared minus 30x plus 9, the factors of 25, that would be, if we are going to distribute, no? So, we have 5x, okay, 5x. Then, the factors of 9, so we have positive and negative. Positive and negative 3. Okay. So, if you want to check your answer, now you can multiply this part here. So, we have 25x squared. Now, FOIL method is always the one, how do you multiply. Then, we have here, for the this part here, we have negative 15x. Okay. And then for the inner term, we have positive 15x. And for the last term, we have 9 or negative 9. So negative and positive, that means your 15y is already cancelled. That's why we obtain this answer. Now that's 5x minus 3 squared because we have 9. So this is correct. For 36, 36 e squared is 25. Okay, so it says it's prime. So how? Why it's prime? Okay, because if we are going to examine this one, 36, the factors are 6 square. And 25 is 5 square, no? 5 square. But 5 times 5 is 5 times 5 is 30. And we get only, ano here, 20. So the result is prime. Now for this given naman, we have 18x cubed plus 18x squared plus 98x. So we need to find first the common factor. Okay, and the common factor is 2x. So 18 divided by 9, 2x is 9x squared. Okay, because the lower exponent of x is x is 1. So need only 2. And then 42 or 84x squared divided by 2x is 42x. Okay, and then 98x divided by 2x is 49. So since 9 and 49 are perfect square, so we can have a 3x plus 7. How? 9 times 7 is 21. Or, yeah, 21. So 21 plus 21 is 42. So that's why this one is correct. Okay. Now let's have this one. So how do we factor perfect square tanom? Yeah, so first, the sign of the second term in the squared binomial is always the same sign of the middle term in the trinomial. The first and last terms of the perfect square trinomial must be positive because they are square. So for example, the polynomial x squared minus 2x minus 1 cannot be perfect square because the last term is negative. Perfect square trinomials can also be factored using grouping or the FOIL method. So although using the method of dissection is often easier. Okay, now let's factor this part here. So we have x squared plus 8x. So the factors of 16, okay, so we have 16, that is 4. No? So since we have here x, then for 16, we have positive 4. No, positive 4. So, how do we know that our answer is correct? So, 4 times x is 4x. 4 times x is another 4x. So, 4x plus 4x is 8x. So, you have to always check if your middle term is correct. So, that's why we can answer this as x plus 4. Okay, close and open parenthesis square. Okay. Next, we have here 3a. Okay, so the factors of 9a squared, we have 2, 3a. And then we have 64. And 64 is a perfect square with factors of a positive and negative 8. Positive and negative 8. Or both negative 8, no? So 8 times 3 is 24, 24 plus 24 is 48, okay? So both negative 8s, or that is 3a minus 8 square. Got it? Okay, next. We have here 49y squared, so I think we got answer here, y. Okay, 7y, and then we have what negative 3y. Okay, so we have here 7 times 3 is 21, 21 times 2 is 42. And then for 9, we have 2 negatives, that is positive 9. So we can say that is 7y minus 3. Okay, easy, right? Actually, this one is just easy, no? So, okay, what about this one? So, because the exponent, no? So, we will hati, no? Or what we call this, we can we can divide, no? So since we have 12, we can divide it by 2, that's 6. 6, okay? 6. And then, for 9, we have negative, what negative? 3t. 3t, okay? 3t. Okay. So we have here 3 times, we have 3, oh, okay, why this one is negative. So that means this one is a prime, no, this is not factorable, okay, so, right, this is prime. That means it's already in a Lewis form and it is not factorable as perfect trinomial. What about number 5? Let's try. Okay, so we have here 3, 6 times 2, say, okay. So this one is perfect square. So because una-una tingnan if the given is a perfect square. And also you have to consider the middle term. Okay, next, let's have this one. Okay, so since we have negative x, I think we have here x minus 3 square. Okay, then we have here 2y. 2y times 2, that's 1, no? The square, okay? So 2y times 2, 2 times 2 is 4y, okay, correct. Then for number 8, we have c minus 10 square because 10 times 2 is equals to 20. Okay, so just always consider your middle term. And then for a, we have 64, 8 plus 8, 16. So we have a plus 8, a plus 8 b square. Okay. Then for number 10, we have a plus 6 square because 6 times 2 is 12. Okay, next. So I'm thinking of a number, the square root of 3 times this number is 20. What number could I be? Alright, so we can discuss this now on this problem. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Mathematics rightly viewed possess not only truth but supreme beauty, according to Bernard Russell. So guys, thank you so much. I love you all.